Hey everyone, it's Dave. Welcome back to another video. Thanks so much for tuning in as always. Today, before I get into the main meat of the video, I just wanted to mention a couple things. You may notice down below there's now a join button for channel memberships below the video. I did finally enable this after getting prompted by YouTube several times, kind of poking me with messages saying turn this on. Basically what it is you can become a channel member, get a few perks, and you pay a few bucks a month, kind of the equivalent of, you know, buying me a drink once a month is kind of how I think about this. But I do want to kind of be the worst possible salesman here and say that, you know, just subscribing and watching the videos is more than enough and very much appreciated. And if you're really, you know, early on in your investing career, starting to build out your portfolio, by all means, I think the best thing to do is just focusing on saving as much money as you can and putting that towards your investments. So this is really just there in case some people do want to become channel members and give back. I've seen a bunch of that lately on some of the live streams and stuff like that. Been very surprised and grateful for the support, so I figured I'd just throw it out there. But yeah, definitely if you're still building out the portfolio, your own investment portfolio, I would encourage you to focus on that. So with that out of the way, I wanted to take a look at Electron's demand and the trajectory of the launch cadence for the Electron program for Rocket Lab. Obviously today it's a very important part of the company. They really need it to continue to scale in order to have the Electron business break even and eventually become profitable at around a 50% gross margin is what the projections are for. And we do know Rocket Lab doesn't really like to say it outright, but we know it's more of a demand issue than a supply issue. It's been said several times, you know, there's never been a payload waiting for a rocket. They've always had rockets available for payloads. It's also been said several times that the factory is capable of pumping out one Electron per week. Not that they're doing that right now. They would have to invest in some things to, you know, speed up the production rates, but they do have that capability. And clearly, we're not launching one per week yet. So we're more demand constrained than production constrained. So that being said, though, things are moving in the right direction. Rocket Lab has been growing their launch cadence every year, getting towards the profitable mark. At 24 launches per year is where the system hits the goal of the 50% gross revenue, according to the company. And I'm pretty sure even around 20 launches, you know, it would still be a nice little profitable business. I haven't done the full math, but maybe like 25% gross margin or something like that is pretty good. So really important for the company that the demand continues to grow and the customers are there for the Electron business to scale. And we did have several big contracts announced recently, a lot more launches added to the future manifest in the backlog. So I figured it was a good time to take a look and see, make sure the company is on track to hit those 20 launches next year, 24 the year after that they have been projecting and that they think they will hit. Figured it'd be a good idea to do a little bit of research on my own and see if I agree with these numbers. I think Rocket Lab's management has been pretty reliable in hitting their projections that they do put out. But there's no reason why, as investors, we shouldn't do some of our own research and make sure that we verify the claims of management, not just for Rocket Lab, but for any company you're investing in. Do your own due diligence and your own critical thinking. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. If you haven't already, I hope you'll hit that subscribe button by the end of the video, and every like does help out with the algorithm. The first thing I wanted to look into is the current trajectory that the launch growth is on, get an idea of how things are going. And for this, I turned to an awesome chart made by Chris on the Discord. So thanks, Chris, if you're watching. This is on Flourish, I believe the platform's called, just giving us a good idea of how things are growing. Yes, we did have a COVID dip in 2021 that was a bit disappointing, but we do still have a pretty solid growth line here for the company. We've had six launches. I believe this isn't including the HASTE launch so far for the year, and definitely on track to continue to beat 2022, as we can see by the quarterly results. So going into more detail, I made this one ourselves. I'm just trying to figure out, is the trend our friend, looking at the launches? And I, as you can see, the ugly red line I drew here. We did have a bit of flatness early on, even a little drop there. But lately we are on a growth line that seems to be consistent with hitting that launch cadence that we're projecting. Obviously, orange is projected launches, blue is the launches we've already had, and we're partway through into Q3 now, so we're having some delays with this latest launch, which is unfortunate. There's a few minor issues with the rocket. I'm sure they'll get it off. I do think they'll probably still hit 15 launches this year, but it's a tough task, so, you know, if there is any more future delays, it's possible to me it'll be 14, but hopefully 15, and then continuing on the growth rate to 20 and 24 before kind of leveling off at 24, you would think. No growth curve can go on forever, and that's kind of what they're projecting, although, you know, if it did go past 24, there is the capacity for that, and that would be just, you know, even better, really, especially with reusability thrown in the mix. So from the chart point of view, it's looking okay. Maybe we need to accelerate a little bit in the back half of this year compared to the first half of this year, but still doable, I think, and still kind of on the trend line. Looking at Main Street data for the launch backlog, because the next thing I wanted to see was, does the backlog support this many launches? Do we have that many customers already signed? Took a quick look. Backlog's actually grown for launch services, the light blue, to the largest it's been basically since Q2 of 2022 when they started tracking this. And by the way, there is a referral link to Main Street data if you're interested in checking it out in the description down below. They do have some pretty cool charts for some different stocks in there, and there is a premium version if you decide to sign up for that. It does help out the channel, but even the free version is pretty useful at times. Anyway, we're looking at a launch backlog here of 161.9 million according to Main Street data. That comes out with a average selling price for Electron. They're targeting about 7.5 million. It may still be a little lower than that, but that's kind of the target. That comes out to about 21 launches. Now maybe it's 22 and the average selling price is a little lower, more like 7 million, but it's somewhere in that range, 21 to 22 launches in the current backlog. So if you're planning for 20 launches next year, and we have, you know, 21 in the manifest right now, seems pretty good. Like, there's definitely enough to support next year's launch cadence, but you do want to make sure contracts are coming in and being signed at a rate that can support that kind of continued progression and growth. So that's what we're going to look at next. So next up, I just want to take a look at the deals Rocket Lab has been signing to try and figure out if they can sustain a rate of 20 per year next year and continue to accelerate to 24 the year after that and beyond. And unfortunately, the company doesn't really provide us with a lot of aggregate numbers of launch contracts they've signed each year, at least that I've seen. So I'm going to do a little bit of a detective work here, look through all their different launch announcements over the past year, try to kind of paint a picture of the amount of contracts they're getting. You know, when you see these, each one off is exciting and a big deal, but we really need a higher level view of how the business is coming in and how demand is looking. So first off, Q1 of 2023, we had a big contract with Capella Space. This is for 4 launches. It is planned to be in Launch Complex 1, but it can be changed to Launch Complex 2 if needed. And it's always good when you have a returning customer. It's a good sign that they're happy with your services. And obviously, they do prefer these multi-launch deals as opposed to the one-offs. So a big 4-launch contract is a great way for Rocket Lab to have started off the year. Next up, we had in early Q2 another NASA mission added to the manifest. This was the Starling mission, which was remanifested from Firefly over to Electron. Next up, in early Q2 of 2023, they signed contracts for multiple new undisclosed commercial satellite customers. And several satellites remanifested to Electron's 2023 manifest from another small launch provider. So this is very vague and came in kind of after the regular earnings because it was happened, you know, it's something they wanted to highlight into the next year. So a little bit confusing because we do know they already did highlight, they already did Tropics. They signed that in 2022. So I don't think that counts as one of the remanifested ones. They already previously pointed out Starling. So I don't think taking that from Firefly is another remanifested one. So I think there may be some other unannounced signings here, but definitely hard to be sure with the kind of vague wording we're given. And then in the Q2 earnings call just recently, this was kind of the big announcement that made me think I should really look into this further and see what kind of rate these contracts are actually being signed at. Very exciting. We had 5 launches for Black Sky, 2 for Cinespective, 2 secret sauce mysterious launches for government agencies or entities, 1 more haste launch. So some things I had here, there was already 1 haste launch that went off earlier in the year, and we don't really know for sure if that contract was signed within 2023 or 2022. The other thing is there's no signs of Black Sky or Cinespective here being remanifested from other launchers I can find, so I don't think they're being referred to here in that previous slide. This is something else, so still trying to put my finger on what these launches are. If it's not Tropics and it's not Starling, let me know if you have any thoughts on that. And then next up, we had a recent announcement, 2 Electron launches for NASA, very similar to what the Tropics launch was. It's kind of like a weather-related stuff. They're small sats, and they'll be launching in 2024. So that's another 2 launches we've signed this year. And I think there probably is a good chance that these 2 NASA launches are the ones that were here being secretive, and maybe they just had to wait until NASA's official announcement before Rocket Lab was allowed to announce it. So perhaps that's where we know where those came from. But that still leaves us not entirely sure what this is. And then the undisclosed contracts for commercial satellite customers, you know, that could be something that we haven't figured out either, potentially. Kind of frustrating to try and get to the bottom of all this, I know. So total contracts for launches signed so far in 2023, that leaves us with 2 for Capella, NASA Starling is 1, Black Sky is 5, Cinespective is 2, Prefire is 2, Haste is 1 or 2 so far. Then there could possibly be a few undisclosed customers. So that's 15 pretty much confirmed around there so far over the 8.5 months we've had this year. And I was just curious what kind of rate we're looking at. That's about signing 1.76 launches per month over the first 8.5 months of this year. So the one thing you have to worry about is obviously I just did this right after we had that big announcement of so many new launches, and these things do often come in lumps. You get a bunch, then you get none for a while. So I may be making this calculation at a bit of a too optimistic time, maybe waiting another month, and if we don't get any more launches, that would be like a more realistic rate that they're being signed at. But right now, at least so far in this year, 1.76 per month. If you do the math on that, 12 months in the year times 1.76, that means they're signing launches at a rate of about 21.12, you know, roughly. Obviously, you can't have 0.12 of a launch. So they are pretty much making enough signings to support that cadence for 20 launches next year, which is definitely the main bottleneck for Electron. So just summing it all up here, I do think they are signing enough new contracts to support the growth rate we want to see in continuing that curve climbing up the rocket cadence, the rocket launch cadence. So I think mostly I'm pretty satisfied with how this growth is going. Obviously, I'd love for the customers to be lining up out the door, having so many that they can't, you know, build enough rockets to support the demand. That's not where it is right now, though. And even, you know, 20 to 24 launches per year, if we get there in 2 years, should be a good little ongoing business for the company at a 50% gross margin rate. So what do you think? Are Rocket Lab's customers finally getting there? It's been a little slow to arrive. We've heard a lot of talk about the small launch industry growing massively, and it really hasn't accelerated as fast as some of us had hoped, but it is starting to get there. You know, we're starting to see where Electron becomes a viable business, and especially next year, if we hit that 20 number, I think, you know, things are looking up, and the signings are starting to come quicker. The competitors are starting to fall away, where you have a, remanifesting from Firefly. Obviously, Astra's announced they're no longer focusing as much on their Rocket 4.0. They gave up on their Rocket 3.3 system. We know even Relativity stopped doing their smaller rocket, although that was still much larger than Electron. And Virgin Orbit went out of business. So really, other than perhaps ABL still working on their rocket and a few others, Rocket Lab's looking pretty good in the small launch space. It all just depends on, I think, the rideshare market and the value proposition of getting your own rocket, being on your own schedule, and all these sorts of things for small launch. If this video has been interesting, I hope you'll consider subscribing, giving me a like, and I thank you guys so much for watching. If you made it to the end, I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.